perfect.
It's a grand dog.
It's a grand dog.
All right, guys, can I call this meeting to order at 5:30 p.m.? The agenda item tonight is about the marijuana question issue. We were asked to comment about the public health effects of the commercial availability of marijuana, and I think it's reasonable to do so. I have formulated a sort of a comment sheet, which I think if you all had a chance to read, on my ideas of the perspective of the harmful effects of marijuana on children. That's pretty much where I'm going with this, just because I think that's where the health effects are. I'm not really that concerned about adults. They're going to do what they want to do, but my concern was with the health effects on children.
Mm-hmm.
I guess also I have it kind of in line with my ideas on tobacco, the effects of tobacco on children and marijuana.
Mm-hmm.
And I just thought I'd bring up any discussion anyone had as far as what your thoughts were.
Well, I'm sorry that you didn't get my email. I sent an email to all of you regarding this on March 5th that it was not received. And I guess my pesticide statement that I sent in February 22nd was not received.
Oh, no.
So I will check with Jean to make sure I have her correct information, because what I'm sending to her is not...
Right. Now, was that the one that you sent us for the last meeting? Did you send Darlene?
I actually made a copy for Darlene.
Okay.
So she could bring to the meeting, because I guess you guys did not get
right.
any of the emails.
No, we
did not.
The meeting.
So I apologize. I will follow up with Jean to make sure you get mm-hmm. correspondence.
Okay. I don't think you need to apologize.
Okay. But, you know, I sent this only because I actually have a number of concerns, and given that I believe I'm the only one in the board who actually has substance abuse disorder experience, I thought I should weigh in.
But yes. Pains me to admit that you know more than I do.
Yes.
On
just
this,
on this.
I have
on
to
this
admit.
Why,
yes.
So, and I appreciate, and it was duly noted by John in last meeting, that I'm an associate member, but I'm going to take advantage of the fact that I have an area of expertise
mm-hmm.
to weigh in on this.
Yes.
And while I read your article, I thought it was vice. And I think part of that also knowing that you have had past experience on what was the board that predated
substance abuse prevention.
Right. So
counseling.
You certainly. And the concerns I had, actually I thought John did an excellent job. I was able to watch your tape last night.
Mm-hmm.
And John actually, unfortunately, you support everything I'm saying is wrong with this article. And you're probably curious now to wonder how you possibly did that. But one of the first things I said to you all is that when people talk about cannabis, they get very emotional. And we just spent a year working on tobacco regulations. And we worked on them because tobacco-related deaths, 6 million people die annually. In Massachusetts, I think it's translated to 9,300 adults. That's pretty much 27 to 30 residents in Reading every year. Massachusetts says under 18 there will be 103,000 teenagers that will be targeted for premature deaths. That 2,800 teenagers start smoking every single year. And we all know on the developing mind, the younger you start, the more of a probability for addictions, and half of long-term smokers die. So, knowing all of this, knowing all of this, and knowing what this board has gone through to get tobacco regs passed, we've had the town assistant town manager talk to us about economic repercussions for these regulations. We've had the town manager weigh in. We've had absolutely no support from the Board of Selectmen that we voiced in public comment or even in the vote you guys took last week. I was bewildered to then have the selectmen adamantly want us to weigh so heavily into this, because I did an extensive research. 60 years I went back. 60 years I could not find any deaths related Now, given that, this was a concern only because I know everyone's concerned about the youth in Reading, and this is what we want to address. I also want to address our regulations to be in line with tobacco, because I think that's so important. So, part of my letter to you was based on the position paper from the American Public Health Association, and that's the November 2014. And their position is about exactly what we did with tobacco. It's regulation. It's not glamorous, but that's where the meat is. Regulate, regulate, regulate for you to mitigate public health risks for kids. So that's why I'm so adamant that we do regulate, but we can't regulate because we don't have retail.
So if you had the chance to ban tobacco from Reading, you wouldn't do it?
Well, we can't ban tobacco because
right,
the federal government
you,
doesn't allow us.
Exactly. But if you had the chance to.
Well, let me finish, though, first, because the regulations, and I'm looking at what's come out of Colorado because of the reduction of teenage use of marijuana. That was through regulations. And that's the concern. I'm also looking at what I get from my journals. There's cannabis that's being put on wax, potent wax, kind of like, remember when you were a kid and you peel off those little candy stickers? These are things, you have to understand, we can't regulate medical marijuana. That's a pharmacy, right?
Right.
We can't regulate pharmacies.
That's not us.
We can regulate retail. That's my concern. I want to have strong regulations. I am concerned about another town having retail that we can't control. Now, that being said, I doubt, this is just my personal opinion, I doubt the Reading voters from last fall to now are going to vote to support this at all. That's not what Reading residents did. They voted in reverse. They had an adamant voice in not supporting question four. You have to understand, question four got a lot of money back by the beverage commission. Alcohol does not want to see any of this pass for a reason. Because if you look at statistics and you look at driving deaths, people don't drink as much when they have access to marijuana. Now, I'm not suggesting in any means that we support one drug over another. I just want us to be very careful that we are not weighing in on something that's political without adequate support. Because we don't have the studies, because the federal government restricts our studies. And I'm not sure we want to say we don't know a lot. What we do know is we know things from the American Medical Journal and from RAND, that in states where there's medical marijuana, there's been a reduction in opioid overdose by 33%. You know, Massachusetts had 2,000 people die last year. That's a concern. I'm not suggesting, again, trading, but we have to look at.
We're not talking about medical marijuana here.
But what we're talking about, John, is the inference of people then. Do they, in fact, have access to marijuana, will that in fact reduce alcohol and opiate use? That's the concern.
And we don't have the proof of that.
Exactly, we don't have the proof. We can't say that until there's more studies. In fact, we can't say a lot except focusing on the developing brain, because that we know.
Well,
we know that from research, which is why I cut out a lot of your article and focused just on developing brain. Because that's really the only thing we can scientifically say, that any drug taken at an early age, nicotine, alcohol, marijuana, we know that. And that's what we should focus on and not drag in things about traffic accidents, this and that. Because the study that you quoted, it's often quoted, but they don't share the whole study, which is that, yes, there's more marijuana found in those traffic accidents, But what we don't tell you is that fatal traffic accidents have been decreased by 30% in those states where there's marijuana. They tell you a portion of that. I don't think we want to get into just picking and choosing bits and pieces of studies. We want to just stay focused on reading youth,
mm-hmm.
as you said. But we're going to have to limit it to just talking about developing brain, as we did with Annie's article, when we really looked at what's the toxicity of drugs. In fact, I think we should rerun his article, along with anything we read.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
So I'm concerned about the health of the entire community.
Yes.
I mean, we are concerned
about
the
children. Men, women, and children.
Not, not,
yes.
And given that the heroin overdoses seem to be focused on 20-somethings, or
mm-hmm.
so I understand, and that there, I mean, there's not a lot of deaths in Reading, but I think the numbers went over the last several years, something like 1-3-4.
Mm-hmm.
1-1-3-4.
Mm-hmm.
So there's an uptick for deaths is in a town of 23,000, 24,000 is not good for heroin. So my question is, you mentioned the decrease in opioid overdoses associated with
medical
marijuana.
They haven't done any studies yet.
Because it's too soon.
Right.
So this is perhaps a stupid question, an uninformed one, but if someone obtains marijuana from...
There's always going to be leakage out from medical marijuana. That's how they got the information.
No.
Yes.
My question is, so if they purchase it from somebody, a dealer,
right.
and who's not, it's not a store, I always have to ask myself the question, what does that person have in their other pocket?
Mm-hmm.
And is it, you know,
right.
does it behoove them to try to sell
mm-hmm.
them benzodiazepines that might lead to Percocets that might lead
to
heroin?
Right.
And so is there any information or a connection
that's
between that?
That's the what's being inferred from the article that Journal of American Medical Association, the RAND Corporation.
Yeah.
It's inferred. You can't say anything yet
right.
because it's not there yet.
Okay.
And that's why I want to be cautious what we put out.
Right.
Because we don't know a lot. And that's really what we can say is we don't know a lot. We can only say this what we know about healthy brains.
Yes, I did write that mostly on NIH and
right.
CDC data that they
right.
had. I'm not sure what exactly how they got that, but I assume
right.
that it was reasonable data.
Right. And unfortunately, the public health, stance
so
is through regulation, and I don't think we want to open ourselves up to talking about regulation when we don't have retail.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we can do. We can regulate.
And the question that remains unknown to me is, so if you have a town, a dry town,
mm-hmm.
Versus a wet town or a town
mm-hmm.
that has stores.
Is this alcohol or marijuana?
Well, with marijuana,
marijuana
let's say.
Okay.
I mean, that's so the ballot question is for over 21 sales,
mm-hmm.
commercial sales in Reading. And the youth are already using at a relatively high rate marijuana, which I assume they're getting from illegal sources. That also worries me, too. But will shifting to retail stores increase the use in youth? And
mm-hmm.
I haven't been able to find any information on that.
Well,
that was
the Oregon, was it the Washington one that said it did. Yeah.
This was a question I had, but again, we don't have retail because there's a very clear guideline that the American Public Health Association sets up for regulations. One is age restrictions. The question is, can we have one that's stricter, and can we set it at 25? Is that something town council can look at? They talked about taxation, basically, what we've done with our tobacco. We drive the price up.
Right.
Because when you drive the price up, taxation, you price you price youth out of the market.
Make sure the
times, dates of retail you can use to control sales. Warning labels. We can't control edibles for medical marijuana, but
we
can control them for retail.
Right.
We can prohibit all type of advertising. We can use more monitoring. We can actually make this part of the, you know, the yearly youth risk assessment. We can control passive exposure.
Mm-hmm.
But these are regulations. That's what John was talking about, regulations.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he was talking about the emotional aspect of what this engenders, because we all worry about our kids.
Right.
But, you know, we pass regulations that will have a direct impact on deaths when we pass our tobacco regulations.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm just concerned about getting involved in something that I actually really do believe,
Arcasa,
thank you, I'm always tripping on that,
yeah,
is in a perfect position to really take a very strong stance and write, you know, a much stronger statement than what I think we can.
I read, actually my wife is a pediatrician, Jesus, she'll probably kill me for burning her. She sent me an article from a pediatric journal about this very topic, and I should say I don't know anything about the connection between legal sales versus this is going to be hard to say, use with youth, and it was, there were no big changes, like some states it would go up, some states it went down, so there wasn't a clear pattern that emerged. In allowing adults access to marijuana and the use of with youth.
Well, the only ones I saw was the Washington one that did go up, Colorado it did not.
Right. There's an Oregon one too, and maybe even an Alaska one. A number of states.
Mm-hmm.
And
again, there's just not enough data yet, and we're
right,
going to be limited until the federal government allows more testing.
Yeah.
More really rigid, you know, scientific.
So do you disagree with the NIH data?
No,
that,
I just think we need to be clear, just focusing on what we know. And be careful not to pull in, because you're pulling a lot of studies that tend to actually be, you're pulling up something that you want to, it's myopic, is what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my complaint about it. I would rather have us not address something that is going to be myopic and look at it just in an area of what we can clearly state, which is on the developing mind, and back off on making so many assumptions.
Yeah, the big assumption for me that I'm uncomfortable with, because I don't have enough information on it, I don't think it's out there, is the connection between sale for people over 21 and the effect on the use in youth. I do think, however, the Board of Health has a big role to play, like with tobacco and with alcohol, and we could probably do a better job than just the article that we put out, where I try to summarize the addictive and toxic qualities of these compounds. But in sending this pediatric journal article that I read, really emphasized the need to stress to youth that it's not harmless for them.
Mm-hmm.
That there's this there's all sorts of perceptions out there, as Nancy
right.
said, very people have very emotional
right.
reactions. But I think what we could do is to make sure that, adults do what adults do, whatever happens, but that the youth, just like with alcohol and tobacco, that they don't see, okay, my dad's having a drink right now, it's okay for me to have a drink. No. And we have to, I think the same message we need to work on with our CASA,
mm-hmm.
to get across the idea that just because if it's legal in Massachusetts doesn't mean it's harmless for kids.
Right, and
in
I think
fact, just the opposite.
Maybe one of the best ways to do that would be to get their parents and adults to buy in on that.
Right, and that's what I think they've done in Colorado in a very successful way, which is why you see the decreasing or flat use of teenager use.
So how would you get adults to buy into it here?
Well, I think you need to make adults,
right.
You know, educate, inform adults. Many adults probably already know this, maybe some don't, but it's not harmless on kids.
Mm-hmm.
Or,
and plus, not just from a toxic standpoint, from what I've read, from an addiction standpoint, you're more likely to become addicted to marijuana.
Even Kevin Hill, who is the guru who Reading actually had come speak, the reason why Dr. Hill, you know, could not come out against question four is because he wants testing, he wants regulations, and we don't have a way to look at people today to say, you're going to be at risk for opiate addiction or alcohol addiction or nicotine addiction. I wish we did, because then that would save us all a lot of trouble. You know, dentists would love it in terms of when they give people, you know, opiates after they pull their teeth, of who's going to develop an addiction. We don't know this stuff. That's the problem. We don't know a lot of stuff.
I also think of it in the historical perspective. When, you know, alcohol was banned during Prohibition, my understanding is that there was some blindness occurring because people would distill their own liquor and they would contaminate it with methanol, which caused blindness. And so I also worry about what all the entire population are getting from irreputable people, as opposed to now they sell alcohol and it's regulated.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they know what's in that.
But I want to be careful that we don't take a position that says we are advocating retail sales, which is why I'm really anxious about being drawn into this, because we regulate, and we don't have anything to regulate. And that's my concern, is that I'm not sure we want to be drawn into something. It's like, careful what you ask
for.
Well,
you're looking at me, so maybe you're asking.
Well, because
I watched
your tape last night.
So there is a, you know, there is a valid question.
Yeah.
You do regulate, and you've done that nobly, and you've done that on behalf of Reading Youth.
Right.
And so you now have an opportunity to weigh in where a ballot question would allow the prohibition of a store that you'd have to worry about regulating. So,
there,
you know, really what this boils down to is
that
it's
there
a pretty,
lies the issue.
Well, no, I think that what's happening here is that the issue in front of you, the request that was made by the selectmen was really quite simple. And it was really focused on the fact that you guys have nobly addressed the issue of children's use of tobacco, for example, and you have regulated in a way that you think is in the best interest of the children. I applaud you for what your decisions are and your decision-making process. I know that it was designed around protecting the young people of Reading. So, we know a few things. One of the things we know is that Reading was not happy with question four. And so the selectmen really, when you get an overwhelming vote, you need to respond appropriately. And so in the case, for example, of the override, there was a large vote, and the response was, don't put it there again. In this case, there was a overwhelming vote that Reading felt strongly about, and the only way to satiate the need for them to think about local regulation would be to give them the opportunity to prohibit. And so that is what's been done. And so because this is a public health issue, I think the very conversation you're having speaks to the fact that marijuana use, particularly as it's connected to children, to the undeveloped brain, is is a serious issue. I think you all would agree with that. I know I agree with that. It sounds like you all agree with that. And so here's an opportunity for the Board of Health to say, in the absence of the ability to be able to regulate, maybe you'd be interested in taking a position on whether to prohibit not adult use, not adult growing, not adults' ability to be able to go where a retail store is, but to take a prohibition opportunity in Reading for retail establishments for delivery, for testing, and for growing. It's really simple as that. I mean,
but see, John, that's not simple for me as someone who treats substance abuse disorders. I have plenty of families who wish that their kids could have bought marijuana because they would still be alive.
So, if you follow that line of thinking, then it sounds like you would prefer that there would be a retail establishment where the kids could buy it for them.
I don't prefer it. I want the voters to make that decision.
I want them to make that decision too, but this is, I think, by
the
very nature of the conversation, a public health discussion.
But this is the complexity I'm saying. It is not simple. This is so complex.
Furthermore, can I say something?
Yes.
I'm getting a mixed message. I don't know if the rest of the board feels that way, but when we were developing our tobacco regulations, so no selectman came to any of our meetings when we were developing
our working meetings. Yes.
When we had our final vote, the assistant town manager came and was pretty persistent and adamant that these regulations would hurt the economy of Reading and have ramifications. She even mentioned the term laying off employees. So if we didn't have, you know, it would be a revenue, it would create a revenue issue. So I didn't hear any Board of Selectmen come to our meeting or say at a Board of Selectmen meeting, they thought that our tobacco regulations designed to take off the shelves tobacco products that are targeted at youth. There was no support coming from the Board of Selectmen on that, and I still don't know where you all stand on.
Well, I think that's.
And now you're coming to our meeting, just before an election, and asking us to weigh in on an even more complicated matter, in a brief period of time, knowing that it took us, how many months did it take us to? I mean, just to get this article, just this physician article approved, that's pretty scientific. It took the ombudsman 3 weeks to review this. And now, so I don't understand that there's a disconnect to me. I don't know if others.
Well,
but others.
Simply stated, the request was made 4 weeks ago. So this didn't happen yesterday. The request was made 4 weeks ago.
Yeah.
It was really prompted by a visit. It happened to be coincidental to the same time that there was a discussion among the selectmen.
Yeah.
And a question was asked of you.
Yeah.
How do you feel that the Board of Health would look at similar type of regulations?
And that's precisely why we're here tonight.
Exactly.
To discuss it. But I don't feel like,
we
don't meet that often. And again, we're happy, you know, we met last week, and we decided to have a special meeting this week to discuss this. I'm bewildered by, there was a lack of interest in our tobacco regulations that I thought really were targeted at protecting youth.
Lives.
So I was wondering if the two selectmen here could.
I'm just astonished at that response.
Well,
I'm shocked.
We're actually here to try to focus on this. Could we maybe try to focus on this?
Okay.
I'd really like to get some sort of a statement out tonight, or at least a decision.
Or do we have to make a statement?
Well, I would like to make a statement. I think the people in town deserve to hear from us.
Mm-hmm.
I hope, I don't know if everyone agrees with that, but I think they deserve to hear from us. It is
a
public health
matter. They deserve a well-thought-out, well-considered, intelligent, science-based decision, because we're the Board of Health.
Mm-hmm.
As Nancy said, and it's so true, and I have the same reaction, it's a very emotional issue on both sides. And we're not here to make an emotional statement. That would be useless. That would be useless. People have their own biases. And marijuana is a maligned drug. I'm not saying I like it. I'm not saying I don't want my kids to do it. But there's all this stigma attached to marijuana. There's not the stigma attached to alcohol. I mean, I've had experiences with my kids. And, I mean, drunk driving is a misdemeanor. It's a misdemeanor. I think it should be a felony, but it's not. People are okay with drinking. Everybody drinks. Everybody does, you know, everybody smokes. Everybody drinks. Not the people in this room and the people in this town, by and large, do not smoke marijuana. Like, they just don't. But that doesn't mean that we have to weigh in because we don't smoke marijuana or our town doesn't. I think it would be misguided for us to come out with a statement because the selectmen demand that we come out against marijuana. That's not the way we work. And
well, I don't think they've demanded that.
It's been very strongly suggested that we come out against marijuana.
Come
and if we don't, it's bewildering. Furthermore, the request was made
in the same meeting when it was pointed out that
that we could all be removed. I mean, that was an issue that came up in a Board of Selectmen meeting about our tobacco regulations, about how to influence the Board of Health. Or remove.
And what recourse
members.
Do they? What recourse do
right.
you have
so,
about if you didn't like the way things were going and the selectman said we have the power of appointment? So to me, I'm feeling a little uncomfortable right now about my appointment to the Board of Health and whether if it would hinge on a quick discussion about a very complicated matter. Again, remember it took us how many months to come up with not banning all tobacco from town, but just banning flavored products.
Well, those were regulations we were talking about.
But it was based on science.
This is even a bigger issue. I mean,
we're not talking regulations tonight.
Because we have nothing to regulate.
Mm-hmm. So it should be easier?
No.
I don't think so.
It's harder.
I like the concept of just staying with the limited piece we know about the developing brain.
And does everyone feel that way?
Yes.
Yeah.
Can we work something out of what we have to do that?
I'd like to reissue this.
Mm-hmm.
This, which says, I'll just talk about, let's see. As stated in the article in this journal, Scientific American, marijuana is known to cause short-term effects such as memory and attention loss, and in some cases, paranoia and irritability. The longer-term toxic effects on adults who use marijuana are more controversial, as can be seen in the article in the New England Journal of Medicine and the British Journal of the Lancet. I'm sure I should say with an accent, but I can't. For example, while some studies suggest a link between marijuana use and long-term brain function, the results are difficult to interpret. In any case, the strong evidence linking tobacco or alcohol with use with highly toxic and sometimes lethal effects on the human body does not exist for marijuana. And then I think you've added to that about the developing brain.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't at the time able to find convincing cause-effect relationship. Again, it's the issue that we discussed last time, the difference between correlation and causality. And so I really, you know, this was a physiological, toxicological-based article. And so I was really looking for causality, causal relations, as opposed to correlative issues. And again, these are complex, not simple issues. So I'd like to at least reissue this. And it does talk about the very damaging effects of addiction, marijuana included,
mm-hmm.
on a family, on an individual and a family. And I'd be very comfortable emphasizing that. And if, and these, you cite a number of articles here where it directly says, where is it, about the effect on the developing brain. Help me here.
What is a developing brain?
And really up to 23.
For men, it's about 30, I think.
That's funny. Not. No, the developing brain really is the most.
It's also who you talk to. Some people
right.
will be a pediatrician and talking about a certain age growth. And it really depends truly what discipline you talk to, if it's medicine, if it's psychiatry, if it's endocrinology.
Mm.
So I'm not sure we can. I personally don't think.
You're not talking about
in.
Single digit age, you're talking beyond.
Oh, yeah.
It depends.
Yeah.
So the real dramatic brain growth happens in the first 10 years. Then there's more brain growth and changes that happen during the teenage years, which I'm sure we're all familiar with.
So the reason I was the guy who asked about the posture on the question, and the reason was purely the nearly identicality in the substance, how it's administered, how it's carried, how its desired effects are achieved. They're both herbs, they're both grown in the ground, they're both sought out to a greater or lesser degree than children, they both are now legal drugs for adults. You have a unique opportunity here, a once in a history opportunity to exert caution. A status quo until now has been medicinal marijuana only. Immediately, all residents get the right to personal use, personal growth, personal carry. The only question that the Board of Selectmen put on the ballot was relative to retail establishments.
Mm-hmm.
But the impact on youth cannot be understated. In general, almost always when you increase supply, you increase demand. And when you increase supply at no cost, which personal growth of plants would do, you increase supply dramatically. You also have no way to police it. The winners here are not the pioneers who charge ahead and go first. The winners here will be those that sit back and watch what happens. You may or may not know there are no regulations at this point in time that we've aware of to regulate.
I would love us to be the first, but Reading doesn't like to be the first.
And I generally don't like to be the first either, because you know what happened to the pioneers? They got shot by the Indians.
But you know, but John, when I first got this message, I literally wrote out a huge email, and then I realized that's really not what you guys were looking for. I was thrilled that you were asking us to develop regulations, because I think that's where we could be so effective in affecting the youth population with clear-cut regulations.
We're probably 2 to 4 years away from that.
But that's not what you're really asking us.
Well, this is a precursor to it.
Yeah. This is,
we can't enable you to write or propose your regs
because
until.
We don't have anything yet.
So we're 2 years or 3 years ahead of that. But
yes.
Prior to that, the thought behind this, we're in an unusual position in history. We have a potential to take a posture that you can moderate later on, but you'll never be able to ratchet it back effectively.
And I would hate to see another town do a very poor job.
What's a poor job in your mind?
Not regulating.
Mm. They are?
Because the tax, and I don't want to get into commerce, because that's not what we do.
We're not
interested in business.
And there's nothing worth
yes.
the cost of a life. I'm not interested
except
in taking.
Except tobacco. See, this is my bewilderment.
So,
This is my bewilderment.
But
we have data.
Correct. But that there are two exceptions doesn't justify that you have three or four.
60 years of literature
yep.
that I've gone through. There is no data of anyone who died from cannabis overdose.
Well, but
can I ask a question?
But that doesn't measure the loss of income, the loss of potential, the loss of family, the loss of social.
I'm not getting into arguing about retail. I don't care about retail.
I'm responding.
Can I ask a question?
Surely.
So we have an opioid problem in this town
yes.
that far surpasses anything we're talking about tonight.
Yes.
If bringing in marijuana saves one kid, and these kids are not under 21, the one that I saw in the casket dead from opioids was 23 years old.
Oh, they're all young.
He can get it whatever he wants. If that kid
yes.
who was a very dear friend of my family, would be alive because we have marijuana in this town. That would be worth it.
It'd be worth it.
Absolutely, hands down.
Let me ask
one
you a question.
Kid.
What about the externalities? If assuming your statement is true, you have
well,
in fact.
Well, it is true. That's medical research.
Assuming that particular individual were so inclined to benefit from that, the calculus doesn't include the externalities from all the other users. There's nothing good that comes without a cost of the good. And so, even if you save that individual, how many others have you impacted negatively?
Well, there's no deaths. So nobody's going to die from marijuana. That's proven. 60 years, nobody's died from marijuana.
I don't think that's proven.
I don't think you can prove a negative.
I don't even think it has an LD50,
no,
for example. What science do you have to suggest that?
I'm not talking about toxicity. I'm talking about death.
That's
what
an LD50 is.
No,
lethal dose.
No, you're talking about a lethal dose. I'm talking about a truncated death due to the use of the drug.
But
you cannot prove a negative in logic.
But
it can't
actually,
be proven.
The only four deaths from Lancet, they actually changed the coroner's report because they were due to asphyxiation. I mean, due to aspiration, not.
I'm not
cannabis.
Talking about adult use. I might lament that.
No, I'm talking about deaths. This comes from. This one's from the U.S. Department of Justice Drug Enforcement. This is one from, you know, neurobehavior. This is from, you know, Lancet. This is from the American Journal. I don't want to get into the debating of whether people should use or not. I'm saying this is such a complex public health issue that I am cautious about us having to be under the gun
mm-hmm.
to get something written, to get to press by Friday, because it is so complex. It is so complex. Do you really want us to do something that you don't want us to do, is what I'm saying.
You do realize that the ballot question is really not tied to whether or not this is moral, whether it's lethal.
Yes.
The ballot question is tied to a singular thought.
And so why
and that,
not?
Can I finish
yes.
my thought?
Yes,
please?
I'm sorry.
The ballot question is, in a singular way, says, do you want to prohibit commercial enterprises in three areas
mm-hmm.
of a legal drug? Because you're allowed to
mm-hmm.
if you choose to want to do that. So it really isn't about the argument between whether somebody dies from an overdose of cannabis. You're telling me that never happens? Okay,
happened.
That's fine. It doesn't certainly speak to a lot of other issues, but that's not the question. The question really is a simple one. From a public health standpoint, would it be, from your opinion, better or worse to prohibit a commercial distribution at three levels? That is retail, testing, and growth. It's really quite simple in that regard.
I think if you listen to Nancy, she answered your question that we don't
I have
know.
Listened very closely to her, Andy, and I don't think that that question has been answered. I think that there's been a lot of issues that have been brought up, and I think very valid ones. And I understand that the battle will rage for quite some time as the regulatory environment tries to sort itself out. This opportunity that is being presented and it's really up to the voters. That was mentioned, I think, by the chair at the last meeting, and I
mm-hmm.
totally agree. The voters will decide what they want in their town. And that's going to happen whether you take a position or don't take a
mm-hmm.
position,
mm-hmm.
because that is a ballot question that's going to be on there.
Yeah.
It seemed to the Board of Selectmen that there are public health implications around this topic. And so we thought it would be valuable for you to think about the singular question of the retail establishments in Reading, and does that have a public health impact that you'd like to comment on? If you want to make no comment, then you can make no comment,
mm-hmm.
of course. But in keeping with what I think you guys have done a good job at, which is to look hard at the protection of our young people, this seems like something you'd be interested in opining. Now, if that's not true, okay. I mean, look, this isn't political. This is not. It has nothing to do with that. This is really the voters are going to be exercising their rights And those rights were demanded by the passage of question four. Question four said a town can choose to do exactly what we're doing.
And if it doesn't, it gets it by default.
That's correct. So all we're doing is...
Say that again? If we don't vote, then we...
If you fail to take a position, the position is nothing is prohibited.
It's really not technically a Board of Health issue. It's a zoning issue.
Oh.
It's a land use issue.
Oh.
So that's the ballot question.
Oh, okay. Whether or not we can have...
Right.
Okay.
But I misspoke, actually, John. You're right. Nancy didn't answer your question. I think she said that we don't have the data to answer the question.
Well, that's a whole different matter.
Yes.
Now, it strikes me that, I mean, the chair seems to think that you guys can do something if the rest of you don't. You know, no one's here to tell you how to think or what to do. That is the last thing that I'm interested in. I know that that's not anything that any of the selectmen are interested in trying to tell you what to think or how to opine as a Board of Health. However, we thought that it made sense because we try to be as interactive with as many of the boards and commissions and committees that we possibly can. This seemed like it had certain implications, and I actually do think it does, and it really isn't about a moral judgment, it's not about a medical judgment. Those things we've kind of gone around the proverbial mulberry bush
so
here.
So what kind of a judgment is it about?
So
yeah.
Do you think it would be better? I think the question here is simple.
Better based on what? What does better mean?
I just think it's a public service. It's a service to the people from the Board of Health.
I agree, and we would be doing them a disservice if we...
By giving them an opinion?
Based on not enough information.
Okay.
I mean,
That's the opinion, then?
I mean, I started to look into this. Someone that I know who's also an addiction nurse sent me a packet, a really interesting, very dense, fascinating packet on addiction, and I don't know anything about this, and I started to read it. I got it Sunday. I mean, I would love to pore over this stuff and look at all the data, look at the stuff from Colorado. I mean, I think I told you, I went to Colorado, and I was very surprised about how they were handling the whole thing. I thought you just went into the candy store and, you know, there it was, and it was nothing like that. I mean, they treat it like a drug, even at the recreational level. It's labeled, it's in a child-proof cap.
Because it is a drug.
Right, and I'm not saying, again, I don't know how I'm going to vote as a human being,
yeah.
You know,
yeah.
As a mother, as a veterinarian who, you know, may have more animals with this toxicity, which has happened in
mm-hmm.
Denver. But my point is, it would be really irresponsible to as a group to come out with a statement other than, I mean, my comfort level would be to say, you know, information, and if it is voted, fine. If you vote no, fine. If you vote yes, fine. If you vote yes, then we would be, you know, more than willing to regulate.
No, a yes vote would actually eliminate retail.
If you don't want to prohibit, then we would be, you know, willing to go back to the drawing board. We have a little more experience with these regulations and you know, make them somewhat probably along the lines of the tobacco regulations.
And so what you're suggesting then, if a no vote, in other words, if the voters of Reading say that they would like to have recreational shops,
mm-hmm.
that if that is their decision, then of course you would work, I guess, the same way you work now. You do have certain empowerment based on existing state regulations. You don't write regulations, you draw from the well regulations,
right.
Which don't exist.
Right.
Actually, we do write regulations.
We
do write regulations.
I get that, but you draw from the well of available regulatory.
No, sometimes we make reasonable regulations.
But that's where
it would be approved by council. I mean,
that's where the American Health Association gives us our.
So, I mean, really, it's a pretty simple question.
Mm-hmm.
I understand it's a complex issue. I'm not denying that it's a complex issue. And I'm certainly not denying that there's an absence of a regulatory environment in the state of Massachusetts for
mm-hmm.
recreational shops or use, a whole myriad of things.
Mm-hmm.
All of that, very complex. However, there is this one simple thing. You can have shops in your town, or you can choose not to by a vote of the voters. It struck me, and I think it struck the rest of the selectmen, that since you do have an interest in the health and welfare of everyone here, with particular focus, I might add, and laudably so, around our young people, that you might want to have an opinion on this ballot question. If you don't want to have an opinion, okay, but it seems to me that that really is what we were looking for, was an opinion about retail shops, not the complexities of what Nancy's talking about, or any of, it's not a moral thing.
No, we understand.
I think we would like to have an opinion, but we don't have enough information.
Right, I think.
In fact, what I wrote to all of you was just that. There are still plenty of questions about how legalized marijuana will affect public health in the future. Some people have expressed concerns that powerful THC loaded varieties available today could potentially have more of an impact than we know, especially if used by young people with still developing brains. On the other hand, if people are using marijuana instead of more dangerous substances like alcohol or opiates, there could be some benefit to public health. So far, it's hard to say how legalization will impact either of these.
And
so
more studies have
to be done.
And I bow to your expertise on this, and the reading that I have done supports that. I mean, so there are some statements that I've read in the medical literature that say there could be benefits to the regulation, regulated sale of marijuana as opposed to the illicit sale of marijuana. And I've heard arguments to the opposite. So it reminds me of when I was in graduate school, if you asked 10 different professors the same question, you get 10 different answers. And it's frustrating.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think we're in, like Nancy says, we'd like to give you some scientific advice on this, but I don't know. I'm not comfortable with my knowledge and the knowledge
mm-hmm.
that's out there. I don't think the answer is out there.
But
well,
it seems like though that in the absence of evidence, caution needs to take the first position, and caution would seem to be preservation of the status quo. Until there's new data, there is no new data. If there's no new data, why does the process change? And if the process doesn't change, that's the posture that the question one asks voters. Do you want to leave it as the status quo until more data appears? The prohibition that comes out of question one can be undone by a future board or this board if it's still around. So think of it as,
or the voters,
a very large pause button. But this was as much born out of caution that the lack of evidence drove no change in behavior until evidence appeared. The lack of evidence doesn't compel you to make a change now in order to get evidence. There'll be plenty of evidence quite shortly.
But that's where I have to beg to differ. See, we have evidence already on medical marijuana.
I'm simply talking about youth.
What I'm talking about, though, John, is youth.
So I'm
uncomfortable with saying something that's myopic when it comes to cannabis. From a public health view, and that's what our board is public health. So that's my worry. That's why I kept saying, how come we don't let, Reading Coalition make this statement? I think they're great to make the statement.
They probably will.
They will.
Yes.
Just to clarify the earlier comment, I was astonished, and the reason, Andrew, you felt perhaps there was an earlier comment, I was astonished that there wasn't a position. So when it first became evident during that meeting 4 weeks ago that there wasn't, that's what kicked up the interest, because I assumed, perhaps wrongly, that after October, when
mm-hmm.
question four passed,
November, actually.
November 4, that the subject matter of tobacco would have naturally driven it. I had no reason to believe otherwise, and so when it didn't, I was inquiring, was that in fact the outcome, and I was surprised when it wasn't. That's why there was a delay. It wasn't any lack of interest.
We've been focusing on the tobacco. We haven't had any time.
The evidence there is really clear,
mm-hmm.
And I think, if I'm understanding Nancy correctly, we're not in a position to say. I mean, you say the status quo would be protective. That may be wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But you have no data that says it's wrong. Your data doesn't take you there.
Right. So, I mean, that's why I'm reluctant to weigh in. The status, again, like you said, the status quo is protective. That's not necessarily the case.
But you have no data to say otherwise.
Mm-hmm.
So why do you change?
So, Nancy and Andrew, it sounds like your position is that you would like to be able to see a retail establishment that you could regulate, and therefore...
I know, but see, that's you're putting words in my mouth.
I'm not putting them there. I'm asking if
what
that's...
What I'm saying is...
That's where I'm listening. That's what I'm hearing.
I'm saying the way to mitigate the public health impacts of marijuana is through regulation. That's the way we mitigate... this is talking about public health.
Okay.
So the way to mitigate the public health risks are through regulations. But we have nothing to regulate.
So it sounds that, so the natural, for me, maybe I'm wrong.
And
the natural, can I finish,
okay,
please? The natural conclusion of that statement would then be, if you need something to regulate, then you would have a position against question one, because question one won't allow you to regulate anything, because there won't be anything here to regulate.
Isn't that crazy?
I don't think that it's that crazy. I mean, but is that what you're saying? That you want something to regulate?
I'm saying this is a complex issue, and you're asking me to simplify something that I wish I could, John,
okay,
but I can't simplify this issue, and that's really the honest truth.
Okay.
I cannot make it simple.
No one has asked you to think a certain way.
No.
So whatever you guys opine,
yeah,
will be what you opine. And that will be what the citizens will know, that, you know, the Board of Health has made a decision in the following way on this topic.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever that is.
Can I ask
a
question?
Yeah.
Sure.
So when the selectmen decide, and this is an honest question,
sure,
to come out against... I can't remember yes or no, but to say we want to not have the dispensaries.
It wasn't about against. It was about responding to the
That's
voters.
My question. So so you guys don't sit and go through this stuff on your own and say, do we think this is a good idea or not, and what do we think it's going to do for the town, and the complexity of regulating it. You basically do what the constituents, you think that they want.
Question four said you have an obligation as a Board of Selectmen.
Oh.
To make your mind up, or we'll make it up for you.
So
as a state regulation, you may, if you choose, in one of a variety of ways, we've been counseled by town council, whether it's a ballot question, whether it's a local initiative, whether it's, and I'm drawing a blank on the other one.
Town meeting.
A town meeting.
Or a bylaw.
A special act.
Okay, so there were several options.
Or a special act.
And there's a debate,
okay,
since no regs exist. It's not entirely obvious which of these three are necessary, so there's a bit of belt and suspenders going on. But if you want to take a posture, now is really the only time to do it. If you fail to take a position, it will be made for you in the affirmative, by default.
And then once, if it became that we had dispensaries in town, we could never get rid of them?
No, you'll always have dispensaries. Medical marijuana is not touched. Medical marijuana.
So this is medical. This is just recreational.
Exactly.
Recreation.
Exactly.
Recreation.
Exactly.
So okay. So but if we agree to have retail dispensaries in town,
that it does not confuse.
Recreational.
Does not
recreational.
Dispensaries. I view as a. It's a sale. It's a point of sale as opposed
okay,
to.
Okay. So if
you're not
we
needing
say,
a prescription.
If we say we're going to allow marijuana to be.
Retail.
Sold in Reading.
Recreational
marijuana.
We've already said we're not going to do medical, or we haven't even gone to
medical
that.
Is
we
by
have,
right. It's all
zoned.
Throughout the state.
So
it's
we
by
could
right.
have we could have that.
You
we
could.
So I
zoned.
Could open up a medical.
We have a
marijuana.
Place zoned
yeah.
in this town
okay.
already
for
medical
marijuana.
Okay. So if we decide that we're gonna get a recreational place,
yeah.
Can we never get rid of that?
It's hard to know, but it would seem unlikely because...
It appears, the current legislation appears, and this is why we needed to react. Because the legislation, question four, really said, towns, here are your two options. Do nothing, and it will inure to you over time the way that it lays out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Which is that you will have shops, they'll be able to be open, or... You can choose, at this time, the following courses of action.
Right. Okay.
One
so
of which was vote of the voters. And so when you look at it in a time window, I mean, we didn't just do this in a vacuum because Reading said they were more interested in being against four, but they did say that. And so the selectmen have an obligation to the citizens when a vote comes to try to respond to that. And with the passage of question four, there was a brief window of opportunity to exercise and give the voters a chance. Matter of fact, the law says it's a vote of the voters is really the only thing that can cause this to happen.
Can't be a vote of town.
And then there's a window of opportunity when this goes on. And we only have this vote of the voters available within the time frame allotted.
I mean, it's unfortunate.
It is,
I think as a voter, as a non Board of Public Health meeting person, Board of Health person, I would like more time
And I do understand that. And the interesting thing that John has mentioned, and I think this is very true, is that let's say for purposes of argument at the moment, that the voters hold true to where they were in November and say yes to question four, prohibiting the recreational retail operation.
Four.
I'm sorry. Question one, the ballot question that will be at the local election. If they say yes to that, okay.
That will prohibit.
But it doesn't prohibit for all time.
It's just for right now.
What it does is it prohibits and then lets the town of Reading and its voters watch this whole thing unfold.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to unfold over probably the next 2 years as to what the regulatory environment, the Cannabis Commission, all of those things will unfold.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, this has been going on in the State House every day now for the last 10 days, that there's been a committee in session. They're working on where they're going next. They were in a position to push out the window of time a little bit and took advantage of
that.
We, on the other hand, only have one opportunity to cause this prohibition so that we can stand back and wait and see. And then at another time, a vote of the voters could say, you know what, this is actually all the data, maybe all the data that you're finding that finds its way in another direction, changes the hearts and minds of people, and they make a different decision.
Mm-hmm.
They can do that. The interesting thing is, by taking this action, they create the opportunity to make a decision later. By taking no action, they lose their the voters in this town lose the opportunity to set their own course.
It'll be done for them.
So this is a zoning law, right?
No, it's implemented by zoning, but it's a vote of the voters to prohibit, which is the operational act is a vote of the voters, which prohibits. The means by which it'll be implemented is by zoning, but it is
the
vote of the voters.
Second step.
If we did zoning only without the vote, it wouldn't count.
No, I get you. I get that. So the voters are voting on a zoning bylaw that would prohibit.
No,
they're not voting on it.
They are voting to prohibit retail distribution of recreational marijuana at three levels, either by growing, by testing, or by selling in a retail environment. That is.
What do you
all
mean by testing? What's the testing?
So where does the zoning come in then?
Hang on.
Go
ahead.
The zoning would that. So if the voters. This is an important lesson in how it happens in town.
Yeah.
I think it's really important that you hear it. Anybody else that's listening. What happens is, the implementing step is the voter. They make that decision on April 4th. If it's a prohibition. If they vote yes on question one on April 4th, too many ones and fours in here, I get that, but let's assume for a minute they make that decision.
Right.
The next step would be at town meeting, a bylaw, and there is such a warrant at town, it's now done, waiting for town meeting. And town meeting will then vote up or down on that bylaw, which that now becomes a zoning issue, okay? The voters decide whether they want it or not.
Right, and if they do want it, it goes to the bylaw.
If they want a moratorium.
You're voting in favor of a prohibition.
Not a moratorium. Prohibition.
Double negative. You don't want it.
All right, so if they vote
yes, they're prohibiting.
And then there's no bylaw.
No, then there is a bylaw.
Oh.
The bylaw, then, the implementation, the enforcement is by zoning. You
okay,
said no.
Okay, so there's no
zoning
for it.
The no means no zones for
okay,
it.
Okay, got it, got it. That's
now,
not what I'm saying.
If the voters go the other way and say no,
yep.
that they don't want to prohibit,
yep.
then there's kind of no point. That bylaw
there's
will
no
get,
bylaw. Okay.
That bylaw will get tabled.
Okay,
yeah.
So it's there if the, if it's needed.
Beth, you asked another question that's
about
critical.
The testing.
So there's three components of this. The one that everyone latches onto is retail sales.
Right.
Can you sell it at a gas station? Can you sell it at a liquor store? Can you sell it at a any other place that might sell cigarettes or alcohol?
Mm-hmm.
And we're not just talking about the herb. We're talking about things that use tinctures or oils
mm-hmm.
or
mm-hmm.
vaping products or
mm-hmm.
the stuff in a brownie, the stuff in a cookie, the stuff in a candy bar.
Yeah.
That's all retail. Because the regs are so immature, delta 9 tetrahydrocannabinol comes in all sorts of densities,
mm-hmm.
all sorts of
potencies.
Yeah. potencies.
Concentrations.
There's no uniform way to measure that, apparently. I'm talking about things I don't understand. They actually want to have a testing facility which will say Mr. Smith's grow
mm-hmm.
is at 9 on the Richter scale, but Mr. Jones' grow is at 4 on the Richter scale, so they can uniformly address the potency of the drug.
So if we voted.
You vote
no.
yes.
If we vote
right.
no,
right.
we could have testing centers. In
you could have.
Right.
Well, if you
no,
vote,
you
if the voters vote no to
right.
to prohibit, then
yes. so there can be testing centers.
You could have grow sites. You could have testing centers.
You get them all.
You get them
and
all.
Then in growth
mm-hmm.
like commercial growth,
right.
not like in
correct.
The backyard.
Or no, that's
mm-hmm.
that's by right now. You have the
right
now.
Right,
to
grow
right
commercial
now.
Commercial growth
correct.
And harvesting.
Mm-hmm.
So you take a warehouse
mm-hmm.
space, which is being done. On the
mm-hmm.
medical side right now.
Mm-hmm.
I know,
I've
Fitchburg,
heard.
For example, has a massive
mm-hmm.
Grow site that's going on.
Mm-hmm. Maine.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, in Massachusetts.
Oh,
yes.
really? In
sure.
There are medical
mm-hmm.
marijuana.
Acres and acres and acres.
Yes.
Have gigantic buildings where they're growing
mm-hmm.
Or soon to be growing
mm-hmm.
medical, you know, marijuana for medical
mm-hmm.
you know, dispensaries.
Mm-hmm.
So we just, John, just I want to say, so could we've been throwing out a lot of numbers and yeses and nos.
Mm-hmm.
So I just want to be, I understand it. I'm just repeating it so that we haven't confused people listening or watching.
That's question one.
It's question one. A yes vote would prohibit the commercial sale of marijuana in Reading.
Right. Are
that's
you in
correct.
Favor of a prohibition to?
Yes.
Right,
yes.
And
yes.
and it would be yes, I'm in favor. And that would then,
mm-hmm.
if the voters voted yes on question one, that would vote to prohibit commercial sales of marijuana.
Correct.
That would then go to town meeting. They would pass a bylaw, a zoning law that would zone it out. That would that would be the how it's affected.
Correct.
But I just want voters to know that a yes, it's a little confusing.
A yes
a
causes
yes,
a prohibition.
Right, right.
Yes,
yes
yeah.
causes prohibition.
Yeah.
And then when all that's done,
mm-hmm.
it has to go to the Attorney General.
There's
3 steps.
Right.
And the Attorney General
mm-hmm.
has to sign off that this is a fair and valid election and law. You know, I mean,
yeah.
that the bylaw is accepted
right.
as written.
I have to tell you, I was shocked when we have
mm-hmm.
pages upon
mm-hmm.
bylaws for alcohol. When
mm-hmm.
it can be sold, what time it can be sold, can you sell nibs, can you not sell nibs, can you sell
yes.
cigarettes, how many square feet, blah, 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 blah.
It's regulations.
It's all regulations. We have this much on this.
Doesn't Denver, I mean, not Denver, Colorado,
mm-hmm.
I mean, I was at Colorado and I went to a dispensary, I wanted
yep.
to see how it worked.
Yep.
It is very tight. It's not at a gas station, it's not at a convenience store,
mm-hmm.
it is a building with a red cross on it and they're all in a row.
Correct.
And everything is very tight. And one person, it's like buying a diamond ring, basically. And one-on-one, and they take your ID, and I imagined, I'll take a pack of cigarettes and I'll take a couple of candy, you know. It was very tight.
But that's Colorado. They're years ahead of us.
I know,
none
but,
of that exists here.
But why can't we use, if this does happen, and again, I don't know if it will or not, but it will happen somewhere in this area.
Maybe they will use it, but that's above my pay grade. I have
right.
no idea
no,
what
it's
so for the use of our time, though, I'm a little,
yeah.
I'm not to cut
yeah,
you off,
sure.
but I think we need to redirect back
yes.
to why
yeah.
we met.
Yes.
Yes.
Interesting, though.
Because
oh,
this
yeah.
is what is
can,
so complex.
If I could be permitted, one last question.
Yes.
This is exactly why the board, as an individual group, said, you know what, let's hit pause. There's too many things changing at once. We have
mm-hmm.
no idea. There's no regs. There's no history. There's not a lot of trending. And I don't think we're in a position
mm-hmm.
yet to figure out what the future holds. Let's not be the first here. Let's be somewhere in the middle of the pack. And let's hit the pause button. And the vehicle to do that was the prohibition,
mm-hmm.
which can be undone at any time.
Right.
That was the only thinking behind this.
Which is the very sentiment I have, which is why I'm hesitant to do something. I'd rather have a pause, to be honest, from the board.
So we, you guys have the different conclusions about what a pause is.
Yes.
Well, for me, a pause
is... I mean, that's really what it was.
But I'm being really honest, John. I really doubt that Reading voters are going to change in 4 months. That's honestly, I have a hard time imagining that people who voted no in question four are going to change.
Yeah, but they probably are accumulating as much knowledge as they can on the issue.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I would like to
mm-hmm.
serve the public with the knowledge that we have.
With the caveat that we don't know a lot from a public health view is my concern.
That's a reason to hit pause and say...
Exactly.
Well,
but
a reason
I,
to say leave it alone.
But
so we
there,
don't know.
There are some things we do know.
And that's my concern, is I don't want to be myopic in our article of
okay.
saying
now,
this.
Should we hammer out an article?
I mean, this, it's not going to happen.
I mean,
before the
I mean, I think if we
now, it's not going to happen.
No, and we
yeah.
have a, I have a 7 o'clock.
I mean, here's the problem, John. As Nancy pointed out, there's, I mean, I'm comfortable with physiology and toxicology, and I that's what I wrote to
mm-hmm.
in this article. And you added, I think, some to the toxicity question.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think addictiveness should be underestimated either. That's another, which is part physiology.
But not addressed.
But I think we need to be clear that that's a danger, you know, and that it's not a harmless substance if it's so legally, or just because it was legalized. But Nancy added a whole nother field to what we should write if we were going to inform the voters about that, and that is the whole public health impact of the sale of marijuana in a state. And from what I heard her say, correct me if I'm wrong, is that it could have a health benefit. It may have a health detriment. And to tackle that issue, to hammer out an article on that would be irresponsible. I couldn't, you know, from a scientific point of view, I'm not comfortable doing that. And that's where I come in. You know, if Nancy said it's a clear-cut issue,
mm-hmm.
I'm comfortable sharing the toxicology and the addictive information
mm-hmm.
with people because I'm aware of that. The greater, broader, I think that's what she's saying about myopic. You know, she's calling me myopic, which is true.
No, it's me. It's me.
Well, my article is rather myopic too in that regard, and that's okay. I mean, that was the purpose of the article that I wrote, and I also happen to be myopic.
Mm-hmm.
But there's another broader science behind this, and that is the science of public health. That she, in this particular area of public health, is much more knowledgeable than I am,
mm-hmm.
and she's saying it's a complicated issue. She's not. Tell me if I'm putting words.
Well, it's complicated and it's very emotional, and I don't want us to get drawn into something. You never go grocery shopping when you're hungry, right?
Well,
and that's the concern is the time frame, and even though you said it was a month out, we only meet once a month, and unfortunately that month was taken up with
tobacco.
So have we been able to really sit down and deliberate as we are now to meet your time frame? No.
Well, it's the voters' time frame.
Well, but this was your, but this was something that you did say on your tape.
A month ago, yeah.
Right. Well, no, in your tape that I just saw, you said last Thursday that you wanted something before April 4th.
Yes.
That's what you said on the tape. And we're just meeting really to talk about it today. And that's my concern.
So the position, it sounds like.
Right.
I mean, you know, it seems like the chair is, you know, trying
mm-hmm.
to take you to a place. And you guys
well,
are in control.
Wait a minute.
Of
let us take ourselves to a place.
I do think what you have
yeah.
to do is
so
well,
can
take,
let
take,
let's
take
let
a
us,
position, whatever that is. If it's
yeah.
nothing,
so we hear you. We hear you. So let's talk amongst ourselves,
mm-hmm.
as they say.
Put moments of silence on.
Yeah, so.
Well, you know my position. Does anybody else have, I guess we don't have, we probably don't have time to hammer it through tonight to come up with a statement. Does anybody?
Your position is to put out the information about toxicity in children?
I was hoping that we could come up with a statement this evening, just by what Nancy had written, by what you had written, and what I had written,
Put all those together?
Yes.
I can't do that. I can reissue this, and I think that there's some stuff in here that's cut and dry. Like, people should know it's not for kids.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think not everybody knows that. I mean, when I say kids, I mean, like, not just toddlers, I mean teenagers.
Mm-hmm.
So I think I'm comfortable with conveying that information, absolutely. So those are the two areas where I'm comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
The area on the greater public health implications, the pros and cons, you know, I bow to Nancy's expertise in that arena. And so that's sort of where, you know, I come out on this.
Okay.
Regardless of what we do, if I could just add, regardless of what we decide or to do tonight, I do think it's important that we continue to come out with articles like this that stress the dangers of these substances to the developing brain.
Mm-hmm.
That is, obviously it has the biggest effect on the developing brain in utero,
mm-hmm.
but has an effect on kids in, you know, from 1 to 11, and then it also has an effect after that.
Has the Board of Health said anything about any other psychotropic drug other than tobacco?
I'm sorry?
Has the Board of Health taken a position on any other psychoactive drug, psychotropic drug?
We actually issued an article, I believe it was maybe a year and a half ago, really targeting college-age kids with medications, drugs, kind of the whole gamut. But that's might.
In the opioid one.
And the opioid,
yeah.
Yes.
When we came out with the opioid.
Yes.
It's a huge universe.
That might even be beyond our pay grade.
Both in the
in
the pharmacy, and there's all sorts of things can kill you, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
I want to, moving forward, continue to inform
mm-hmm.
through articles and reaching out to the public about the what we know is dangerous, what we know is problematic. So that's all. I'll let you guys talk.
Well, okay.
I would be in favor of mentioning something about regulations if, and we talked about this a while ago when I think it first passed. I think
mm-hmm.
when it first
back in November,
passed in Massachusetts,
we talked about it.
Yeah.
That if we
we'd be happy to regulate.
Yeah. I just don't think it's
same. Yeah. Same.
So we're not going to, we wouldn't be issuing a statement then.
Well, the thing is, we're bound because if we draft something, if you drafted something tonight when you go home, and then you have to send it to somebody, and then it just has to come to us.
Yeah.
Another, it's the time is not, because
no.
we have to get it, in the, you want it in the paper.
No, that's what I was sort of hoping we could
mm-hmm.
hash
get something
tonight.
Today, yeah. I mean, did you have something crafted?
Well, I sent something out a month ago. Three, 4 weeks ago, and then
I
responded.
Nancy
switched
sent
them.
Her opinions to it.
And then you guys, and unfortunately, you
no,
never
I
got
get her,
yeah.
only heard
right. I sent it out to Jean beginning
got it
of March.
Last week, yeah.
You only
got
it gave Darlene the copies.
Pass those out, Darlene, last week?
Last week, we got it last Thursday.
Right.
Last,
right.
And last Wednesday. Yeah.
Yeah.
We
right.
got it last Wednesday. So, and then your
mm-hmm.
last Wednesday, we also got your revised article with the citations.
We got those from Darlene later on.
So, yeah,
right.
Darlene sent
yes.
them out, I think
those.
The next day or
yep.
something like
yep.
that. So,
But it wasn't a statement, it was just an informative.
Yeah, right.
Yes.
Right. But I think to Nancy's point, the ballot question is is a multi-level question. It's not just about what you and I focus on and write. It's also from the Nancy's specialty, the larger public health ramifications, mm-hmm. and whether it'll be an improvement over what we have now or not an improvement. The science isn't in, and I can't. I'm not
That's
comfortable
why I'm
making a statement.
I'm not sure we want to throw
yeah.
a head in.
Mr. Chairman, as your liaison, and I know the hour draws,
mm-hmm.
I think Beth, you said that you have a hard stop. Mm-hmm. I need to take a report back to the Board of Selectmen
mm-hmm.
on the request that we made of you, and that is to weigh in your opinion from a Board of Health standpoint on question one. So I guess what I'm asking you as we draw to the end of your meeting, will your answer be you have no answer, or will your answer be you're deferring your answer till a time, sometime in the future? I mean, so I guess what I'm saying is,
mm-hmm.
it was a
mm-hmm.
straightforward request, and I know that we've gone into a lot of different directions here, but I have to walk out of here with a simple
mm-hmm.
response to a simple question.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not going to take a position, I mean, if you need a vote in order to do that, okay. If you are, and it doesn't sound like you are going to take a position based on, what a majority of the speakers are saying here,
mm-hmm.
And the people that vote on such a position. So I guess what I'm saying is, maybe you could ascertain what the answer is so I can take it back to the selectmen.
So any motion to defer, because we're not going to come up with a statement this evening. And
yeah,
we can work on Nancy and your adjustments to whatever.
Well, I think it's going to be.
This is strictly around question one.
I'm
asking you about question one, which
right.
is the request that was sent to you.
Right.
Everything else you guys do, you do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
mm-hmm.
what you do.
Right.
You do it once a month. You make a decision
mm-hmm.
about what your agenda ought to be. Sounds like this is going to be a hot topic, but on question one is really what I'm asking you for. What is
right.
the answer to that question?
Well, I think to say to defer is sort of, it's going to be a moot point.
Deferral is kind of,
right.
it sounds
yeah.
like you're going to take, no, I don't want to put words in anybody's
no,
mouth.
Right, right.
But if you're not going to take
that's
a position,
well, yeah.
then,
yeah.
then
we can't,
either
I
vote
we
on
can't,
that and tell me that's what your position
we can't,
is.
We can't.
You have
yeah,
no
I,
position.
I don't feel comfortable with the signs that I've heard tonight
mm-hmm.
and that I've read. Making a statement one way or the other.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you'd actually argue against taking a posture.
So I don't think that I feel confident in the data. I don't think
right.
the data is there for us to make a scientific. We're a scientific advisory board in this way, and in that scientific capacity, we base things on. The larger public health in ramifications, which are mostly epidemiological studies, not my area, Nancy's, toxicity and addictiveness, a little bit more, much more in my comfort zone. And it sounds like we're missing, the data's not out there for at least me to make a statement
so
one way or another.
Way.
I agree. I think I couldn't make a good recommendation.
That said, John, I do really want to emphasize the fact that as a board, I hope moving forward, we take your information and some information that Nancy has
mm-hmm.
and keep hammering away, communicating
mm-hmm.
with the public. Not just on these things, but on the opioid crisis, and right.
Because as it, even if it gets voted yes, right?
To prohibit.
Yes.
Yes to prohibit.
Yes to prohibit.
Then there are other towns, we don't know what the other towns around us are gonna
Of course.
We get to watch that petri dish.
Yeah, so I mean, I think it will be important for us, you know, even if we don't have it in Reading, it will be around us. So our part about keeping an eye on the studies and doing the education piece and educating parents especially so they don't get high with their 16-year-old, you
right.
know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think all that is part
right.
of our, in Reading, whether we have the dispensaries
mm-hmm.
or not, I think
yeah.
it'll still be
good. And in fact, if they vote no on question one, that would
correct.
Allow residential sales
yes.
of marijuana. I'm comfortable with commercial. What did I say?
Residential.
God. I'm mixing my day job and my day job we have commercial, we have residential.
Oh.
So that's I pardon the error there. But I am comfortable saying that if there are they vote no on question one
mm-hmm.
and they do have residential. Commercial. I'm trying to talk too fast. Commercial sales in Reading, and it falls under the board's purview
mm-hmm.
to regulate it. I am comfortable doing so to protect the public health.
But you'll need all those studies that you're
Mr. Chairman, could I ask you
no,
to
not for
a motion
not for you
for the kids
as
stuff.
To what
not
your position is on the request?
Sure.
And you know, I mean, all the rest
mm-hmm.
of it is the process for you guys.
Mm-hmm.
And you guys have to process
it. Do we have a
but,
motion to on what where we are with this? Or?
I don't think we are.
there's no motion to make.
There's nothing.
There's a direct request made.
But
you guys have to decide that you're going to do it or not do it.
Does a request require a motion? Can we just say request denied?
Okay,
if it's request denied, I guess that's you know. But that's one person. Is that where you stand?
I think we've said that we can't answer. We can't give you an answer.
The motion is to take a position.
It would have to be a vote of the board to approve a comment.
Or not.
And there's no comment.
And it doesn't seem like we have.
We're approving a non-comment.
We don't make an action,
do something like we did for the pass the minutes for the tobacco.
What John's saying is that a motion to make a statement would apparently go down X to Y, and therefore no statement would be made. So it's a motion to make a statement. Those are for. Those against. And the outcome is whether or not you will make a statement.
Well,
we have no
we're the Board of
no.
Health. I mean,
there's no statement to yes or no.
We don't have to. We don't have to make a motion.
We don't have a statement. All
right.
Okay.
Did everyone get a copy of the pesticide regulations?
No.
I asked Jean yesterday to send them out to you.
No.
No.
Okay.
I thought Jean was away.
She is away.
Okay.
So can you send them to Darlene and get
them
out?
Right, because I sent them originally in February to Jean. So I will.
Do you guys regulate pesticides?
February.
We're going to be.
We're going to look at some proposed pesticide regulations. Yeah.
Just on
the
ones we can.
Just
on the tree line.
On public property.
Oh, public property.
Just tree line. Town property.
Right.
Just town property.
So if Darlene, you could get those to us.
I will send them to you again.
Send them to me and I'll send.
Yes,
thank
I will
you.
Send them to you.
And what time is it?
7
o'clock. Oh, it's
7.
All right. I took some pictures of the dumpsters that we were talking about last week. You missed the dumpster discussion.
Can you send them to
and,
us?
And I'll send them to
Darlene
and she can forward them around. But it's a problem.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we've known it's a problem.
Is this the dumpsters behind CVS on the?
On both sides. There's on both
I've
sides.
Been back there
I tell
recently.
You, get very hungry for pizza when you're back there because it smells of pizza.
Good to know.
It's quite good. But there was, you know, waste hanging over a dumpster and stuff like that. So, I mean,
okay.
Our health agent is on it,
yeah.
But I thought it would be informative for us to
see
that a picture is worth a thousand words, as they say.
Yeah, I think Bob's working on that, too.
Excellent. Bob Bracey.
Bob
Bracey,
that's
yeah. Geez, too many Bobs.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
thanks,
are we
John.
Back, just one question before you, are we back on our regular schedule for the 3rd?
The 3rd is vacation week. Is that okay with everyone?
I will be around if it's a Tuesday or Wednesday.
3rd of April.
Of the, the 3rd week. Of,
I will be
away. Right, the 3rd Wednesday. I just wanted to make sure it's the same.
So school vacation,
yeah.
We're going away.
Okay.
So you will not be here on the 19th, is that, that's the scheduled date?
I won't be here, but you guys can meet if you want to.
Okay.
Thank you for your time tonight, I've got a 7 o'clock I'm late for.
All right, thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
So you will let us know if.
Yes, I'll.
You'll let us know.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Plan on the 19th unless we hear from you.
Let us know the health agent.
Jean has not been in.
Right, she did mention last week that some, there were things happening.
Yeah.
I'll talk to the.
HR.
HR, talk to Bob, yeah.
Okay, all right.
Okay.
We need a help agent.
Yes.
We all agree with that, right.
So you're the third Wednesday, the 19th?
Yep.
Yes, that's.
Unless he emails you.
That's tentative.
Unless he, right.
I won't be here, but.
Meeting adjourned.
Thanks, John.
Thank you, John.
Good job.